This is an evolution. It continues to grow.
Constantly developing them, constantly evolving them. Great storytelling, more Disney and more Walt. There's cutting edge technology. This expansion will be anchored by Cars Land. There'll be life occurring the moment you walk through the gates. And it transports you away to another time.
We are going to make this park even more amazing.
Floating here right next to me is one of my crewmates, Buzz Lightyear.
World of Color represents the best of what makes Disney, Disney.
Lightning McQueen to get here. Luckily for us, they're on their way right now down Route 66.
Company, Bob Iger.
Good evening, everybody. Thank you for being here. I have a feeling there is something behind that sign. But we're going to make you wait just a couple of more minutes to see what it is. You know, when we started envisioning California Adventure and what it might become, I got incredibly excited. But like everything great, I just could not wait for it to open so that we could share it with the world, and that's what we're doing tonight. Well, as many of you know, the very essence of a Disney park is a great magical world or a special place with wonderful stories and, of course, our great characters, all there to immerse guests, to enchant them, and to create memories that last a lifetime for them. Now, some years back, when Pixar was becoming part of Disney, John Lasseter and I had a long conversation. We were talking about what is the essence of a great animated film, what's the essence of a great Pixar film. And he said a great Pixar film has a great magical world, but one you believe could actually exist with a wonderful story and, of course, those memorable characters, characters you want to hang out with. And in Cars, John and Pixar created just that, a great story and a very believable world, Radiator Springs, and characters, of course, that you just wanted to drive down Main Street in Radiator Springs with or hang out at the local diner or whatever, take maybe even race with. Now, tonight, I think, is a great example of how wonderful it is that Disney and Pixar are together, because it enabled our great Imagineers to work alongside the great animators at Pixar to create a wonderful physical embodiment of that film, and then to invite the world in to actually enjoy it. It's pure joy and inspiration. And so to hear more about that, here is Tom Staggs, the chairman of Walt Disney Parks and Resorts.
Thank you, Bob. Thanks you, all of you, for joining us here tonight. This is really a defining moment in the history of Disney California Adventure and really the whole Disneyland Resort. So not long after the transaction that brought Pixar into a part of Disney forever, Bob had the vision of transforming Disney California Adventure by infusing more of our great characters, our stories, and more of what makes Disney so special into the entire park. And of course, that included the addition of Mater, Lightning McQueen, and all the residents of Radiator Springs. Now, in a little more than a day, we'll officially open our gates and welcome the world into a new theme park, one that celebrates the dreams, the imagination, the spirit, and the optimism of California. A park that we believe will help build upon and extend the legacy of the Disneyland Resort. From the romance of Buena Vista Street to the thrills of Paradise Pier, Disney California Adventure has been transformed into a place where guests can connect with the Disney stories, characters, and music that they love, and create those shared memories that last a lifetime. Of course, the keystone of this transformation is Cars Land, and we could not be more excited to unveil this amazing place for you tonight. I'm here on behalf of myself and of Jay Rizzullo, who oversaw the first 2.5 years of this amazing 5-year journey when he was chairman of Disney Parks and Resorts. So Jay, thank you for helping put us on this great show. I also want to thank all of the phenomenal Imagineers and cast members from across our entire business who worked so tirelessly to bring Radiator Springs to life. In particular, a big thanks to Bob Weiss and Kathy Mangum, whose energy, creativity, and sheer horsepower show in every aspect of this great land that we're going to show you. And finally, I want to thank and acknowledge my good friend John Lasseter and his fantastic team at Pixar Animation Studios. They both created the great films that inspired this land, but their tremendous collaboration and input throughout its development has been vital to everything that we've achieved. John and his team have been incredible partners every step of the way. So please join me in welcoming the creator of Cars, the chief creative officer of Walt Disney and Pixar Animation Studios, and the principal creative advisor of Walt Disney Imagineering, John Lasseter.
Yes, Tom, I've learned a jacket.
The last time I saw him wearing a suit was the Academy Awards. This is, no one told me. I'm feeling a little, Bruce. Here, all right. Thanks.
There you go.
Okay, go ahead. Just carry on. Okay. I'm fine.
All right. Thanks, Tom, for that wonderful introduction. I just want to start by saying thank you to Bob Iger, to Jay Rizzullo, and to you, Tom, for this. You know, investing in the beauty of this Disney California Adventure without you guys, you know, the future guests coming to the land would not have this amazing place that we have now. Thank you, you guys. Thank you, Bob. Thank you, Jay. I love working with the Walt Disney Imagineers and working so closely with them and all the cast members on Cars Land, you know, has been an absolute thrill for all of us at Pixar, but especially for me, because these characters and stories are so close to me personally, you know. Now, wow, I love all of my children, all of the films at Pixar equally. The Cars films are really particularly close to my heart because they combine two of my great passions in life, animation and cars, When I was a kid growing up, not far from here, just up the Santa Ana Freeway, go up the 605 a little, get off of Beverly Boulevard in Whittier. That's where I grew up, about half an hour from here. My mom was an art teacher at a high school for 38 years, and my dad was a parts manager at a Chevrolet dealership. So you can sort of say that basically, I guess I was destined from birth to create an animated film about cars. Now, when we were developing cars, I had the unique opportunity to take my beautiful wife, Nancy. Nancy's right down here somewhere. Yay, Nancy Lasseter! There she is right there. And my fantastic five sons on a road trip across Route 66 to experience life on the Mother Road. So many of the people and the places we encountered along the way served as an inspiration for Radiator Springs and its inhabitants. So, Tom, it's an amazing feeling to stand here right now and see the world that we created for this film actually come to life.
There's so many people that are excited, and I have to say, one of the things that I love most about Cars Land is how every element, big and small, works together to create this immersive world where our guests can enjoy themselves with their family and their friends. But from the attractions, the entertainment, the food, the merchandise, the costumes, even the plants and flowers, everything meshes together to transport our guests to the world of Cars. And thanks to all the efforts of the Imagineers, you, the folks at Pixar, this place really is real at this point.
It is so, Tom, you're so right. It is, you can't believe the immersive nature. I mean, it goes back to the essence of Walt Disney created with Disneyland. You know, where he takes you to another place in another time. Cars Land is so full of the amazing, tiny little details. And the harder you look, the more you will find. And that's, you know, that's what makes Disney, Disney. I can't wait for all our guests to see it. It's gonna be fantastic.
John! Oh, up here! Boy.
Yeah, hi, oh boy. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I want to introduce you to John Lasseter, my alter ego from Cars 2. How's it going?
Hey, I got a great idea for a new Cars 2. It's about a pickup truck with wood paneling, huh?
Oh, wow, that sounds really great, John. Yeah, I'm going to have to think about it a little bit.
Oh, come on! Pickup trucks with wood paneling is the next big thing, dude!
Okay. We'll definitely get together. I'm a little busy right now opening Cars Land, but I tell you what, call my office, okay?
Okay, call your office. Good. I'll get on your schedule. You know, I know it's going to be like next year sometime. But you're going to love it when you hear it. Enjoy the rest of the ceremony, dude. Bye, everybody.
Ladies and gentlemen, John Lasseter from Cars 2. You know, Tom, it was so much fun working with the Imagineers on Cars Land. I got me thinking about, okay, picture this. What would Bob be like if he was a character in the Cars world? Right? Now, think about it. He's always amazingly dressed, right? So he would naturally be a sports car, right? Look at that, huh? Bob Iger is a sports car. Now, he's an amazing family man. With Willow and his boys and his daughters and everything. So, I think maybe he could be a station wagon. What do you think? I think he's a family man now. But, really, you know what? He's the greatest leader of the greatest company on Earth. And this company is really big, yeah, right?
It carries a lot of heavy load.
Yeah, he would probably be a semi-truck, right? There you go. Bob Iger, one of those three things in Cars. Now, but I kept thinking about you.
I was afraid of that.
Yeah. You as a Cars character in there, right? Let me feel, hold on. Yeah. I think you might be a muscle car. Look at that. Huh? Come on. You like that?
Yeah.
That's
my
great.
My boys will like that.
But, like, Tom Staggs is one of the smartest guys that I know. So you could be a smart car. Look at that! It matches your coat! Come on!
It's Bruce's coat.
Bruce's coat. Yeah, but above all, with the amazing additions to the Disney parks, if you are bringing joy to millions of people with your intelligence, your grace, and your good
humor, so therefore, I think you'd be an ice cream truck. Tom Staggs! Look at that. I think he's an ice cream truck.
Okay, I can't wait to see the next car short with me and Bob.
That's going to be awesome.
All right, I think people want to see what's behind this, so I know you brought along some special guests with us
to share
the moment.
That's right. Ladies and gentlemen, please join us as we celebrate the real stars of Cars and Cars 2.
First, from behind the scenes, please welcome the music editor of Cars and the composer of the songs for Mater's Junkyard Jamboree, Bruno Kuhn.
Next, it's the composer of the score for Cars and Academy Award nominee for the original song from the film Our Town, Randy Newman.
Singer-songwriter with a smash hit on both the Cars and Cars 2 soundtracks, Brad Paisley!
Here comes the man who brought combat ship Tony Trehold to life in Cars 2, Lloyd Shore.
Auto parts dealer Tom Bay in Cars 2, Michel Michelli.
Also joining us is the voice of Minnie in both Cars and Cars 2, Edie McClurg.
A vehicle that refuses to ask for directions. Please welcome Richard Kind.
Joining us now is the man whose distinctive voice gave Lightning McQueen's truck Mac his character, John Ratzenberger.
Of Lizzie, Radiator Springs' very own Ford Model T, Catherine Helmond.
Here comes the voice of the monocle-wearing scientist in Cars 2, Professor Z, Thomas Kretschmann.
Joining us this evening is the voice of Radiator Springs' signature sheriff, Michael Wallace. Next, give a warm welcome to the voice of the lovely namesake of Flo's V8 Cafe, Jennifer Lewis.
The voice of Radiator Springs expert on low riding and smooth talking, Ramon Cheech Marin.
And here comes the voice. voice of everybody's favorite Porsche, Sally Carrera, who charmed the white walls off Lightning McQueen, Bonnie Hunt!
And now, straight from the heart of the junkyard in Radiator Springs, it's the voice of the tow truck we all know and love, Tow Mater, also known as Gator Ton Larry the Cable Guy!
Wow, this is awesome, huh? Is this not the greatest thing ever, everybody? Is this not great? I mean, it's almost like we're stepping into Radiator Springs. It's unbelievable, but I gotta say this. It's not complete without two people that should be here. You cannot start any of this without Mater and Lightning McQueen. But lucky for you, they're almost here. They are almost here.
Wow! Now this is my kind of crowd.